It was just another day at the Nexus when I caught wind of a rumor. The talk of the town, a mysterious character known only as the Mole. Intrigued by the buzz, I set out to unravel the mystery surrounding this shadowy figure. With my eyes set on the truth, I set out to confront the hard-boiled suspect known for his tight lips.
You're right, it was me.
Spill it, kid. Why'd you do it?
Oh, you're good. I did spill it. I was having some coffee, and somebody's laptop may have taken a little swim.
Spilled coffee?
He adds another meaning to grounds for suspicion. But forget about that for now. I'm looking for a leak.
Oh, I can't help you there. I don't know if it'll help, but I heard Chlorine say something about the brothers?
It was clear to me that hydrogen was just a patsy, and was just at the wrong place at the wrong time. Chlorine, on the other hand, seemed to be holding back the real juice.
Word on the street is, you've been rubbing elbows with the brothers. What they got to do with the leak?
They're the best when it comes to leaks. I saw it on TV. The only thing they won't drain is your bank account. I heard they took a gig for someone called Princess Peach.
The Nintendo Dame.
If anybody knows more, it's got to be oxygen. I heard there's oxygen in all of the water levels.
It was obvious we were dealing with a top-notch mole. Time to shake down the big fish.
The mole is simply a very large number. Just like 100, 1,000, and 1,000,000 are all words we use to describe numbers, the mole is simply a much larger number. You need such large numbers to count so many nanoscopic particles.
Where can I find this mole?
Everywhere. Solid, liquid, or gas. A mole is just a way to count the particles. What exactly are you looking for?
Describe them to me.
It depends on what it is made of. A mole of larger atoms would weigh more than a mole of smaller atoms.
I see you don't want to cooperate.
I really don't know what you want me to say. I've answered all your questions.
I need a handle, a name.
I suppose a mole is called Avogadro's number. Named after a scientist called Amadeo Avogadro.
It appears oxygen has clammed up. Maybe he's in cahoots. The name he gave me was clearly a front. What he didn't count on was now I had a name and a number. Time to tap into my eagle-eyed insider for more.
Where have you been? I've been looking for you all day.
Sorry, my computer got fried.
It got fried? I thought it went for a swim.
What? Nah, I'm saying my laptop's toast. It even smells a bit like coffee. What do you need to know?
What do you know about a fella named Avocado?
Sounds like a salad. Alright, I could tell you about Avogadro's number. Word on the street is, if you have 12 grams of carbon 12, you've got yourself a mole.
What are you suggesting? I'm the mole.
I ain't saying nothing. Just get 12 grams of carbon 12 and count the atoms. There's your mole. I got a jet. Can't be seen chatting with you.
As I leaned back in my chair, the weight of the revelation hit me like a ton of bricks. The truth was staring me in the face, mocking me with its simplicity. The mole wasn't a person, it was a number. I glanced at the periodic table, its rows and columns taunting me with their secrets. Each element, each molecule, held the key to a mystery. Any of them could be a mole, but they would all look different and weigh differently. The mole could be anything, anyone. I knew then that the case would never truly be solved. The mole would always be one step ahead, slipping through my fingers like smoke in the wind. All I could do, all anyone could do to keep the investigation alive, is to share this film so the search for the elusive truth can continue.